Morrison and all of these ministers and bureaucrats are going to have to live with this on their conscience for the rest of their lives.
In the wake of the damning Robodebt report...
For 4.5 years, Mr Dutton's political party, when they're in government, gaslighted the nation and its citizens.
An apology.
I'm sorry to those people at... That have been adversely affected. I truly am.
And an accusation.
I just caution the glee of the Prime Minister and of Bill Shorten at the moment. Bill Shorten, in Question Time, has sought to politicise this issue from day one. The Prime Minister's doing the same.
This isn't about politics, it's about people.
All you got from Peter Dutton the other day was all the empathy of a rock.
Calls for the former head of the Department of Social Services, Catherine Campbell, to resign after it was revealed she went on leave from her new defence role the day before the Royal Commission made scathing findings against her.
There was a choice open to so many bureaucrats. It was a moral choice. They failed it.
Scott Morrison, who first oversaw the rollout of the scheme as Social Services Minister, then as Treasurer and PM, rejecting outright the findings of wrongdoing against him, calling them wrong and unsubstantiated.
It's not up to me as Prime Minister. I do know Scott Morrison has also shown no contrition whatsoever for the impact that his actions as Minister have had.
Some of my colleagues, they're disputing some of the conclusions that have been drawn in the Commission process, and that's entirely their right to do so.
Now, after decades of vulnerable Aussies being demonised, questions over how welfare recipients are treated by those in power.
What we need to change is the crushing administrative burden placed on people. They have to stand in line at Centrelink. They have to find the magic words on the phone for that tiny bit of support.
Hopefully some of the structural change that comes out of this is recognising that the role of government in this situation for people living in desperate poverty is to provide them a good safety net, not treat them like criminals.
Calls growing to show more compassion.
Australians need to ask how we ever let these dismal politicians generate so much shame.
Yeah, this commission not only found that Robodebt was cruel and crude, but it also really exposed this underbelly of meanness on both sides of politics, where we bash people on welfare. The commissioner herself, Catherine Holmes, she said that the commission reveals that welfare fraud is minuscule. It's so minuscule. So why then are we continuing to punch down as a country?
I just wonder if it is that shocking, because we voted for politicians that have promised this stuff. You know, it was not a surprise, actually, because these governments were elected saying, this is what we're going to do. You know, you remember the election... the budget delivered by Joe Hockey, and he talked about lifters...
And leaners. I mean, he was widely derided for that, being very kind of vitriolic language.
But that was a government that was re-elected multiple times, and it's only, you know, almost a decade later that we're... or 8 years later, I think, that we're finding out what was going on behind the scenes.
I wonder what the accountability here is, because, you know, these findings have been handed down. So what happens? Does somebody just get fired and everybody gets on with their lives? Because the people who've been affected by this, they don't get to do that. So, you know, what does accountability look like?
Yeah, well, also, I think if you look at last week when they were about to announce these findings, and it turned out that Scott Morrison, who a lot of people are pointing fingers at, was on holidays in Italy. It's like, man, this guy really knows how to time a holiday, doesn't he?
Of course, if you find yourself in need of help at any point, for any reason, crisis support is always available through Lifeline. The number is 13 11 14.